with you all. But before that, let me try first whether you can see or not. Okay. Okay, all right. I hope you can see, okay, my slide and my voice here can be heard. Okay. Unfortunately, if lagging, I'm so sorry. Just now also I'm lagging teruk lah. Lagging teruk. Okay, chapter 1 or topic 1, introduction to quality and the performance excellence. Okay. So, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and a very good afternoon. Okay, so ready afternoon.
Good afternoon, miss.
Okay, all right. So, topic one is introduction to quality and performance excellence. Before I go further, okay, I don't want to just say it without knowing what is actually the topic of we should learn. Okay, so number one, when we're talking about the quality, okay, this is from my point of view, and to make you to make you understand it from in a simple words, okay? Quality meaning something that when you perform something, okay, like you produce products, okay, or maybe you offering the services to your customer, you're giving something satisfaction to them, okay? That is quality. Because we cannot just measure based on, we can measure based on the features, the function, but the another tools to measure is we call quality. Antara saya buat dua bahasa sebab saya faham tak semua yang mungkin okay Englishnya ataupun tak semua orang okay BM-nya. Jadi campur lah kita International Islamic College. Okay. So, bila kita cerita tentang quality, ukurannya adalah yang terbaik. Bila customer melihat sesuatu quality tu, quality apa yang berkualiti? Produk tu berkualiti atau tidak? So how to measure? Maybe they measure in terms of the features, the function. So the main to measure is the quality. Okay, and how to say that it's quality? Okay, how to say that the product is quality? How to say the services is quality? Number one, it meets satisfaction. Dia menemukan atau mendapat kepuas hatian pada siapa? The customer. Okay, you and me. When I teach this subject, do you satisfied with the quality of teaching? How we want to measure the quality of teaching is different, kan? Ada orang kata, saya sukalah quality teaching medium ni, dia buat video. Ataupun saya tak sukalah bila buat live nanti kita tak boleh tengok balik. Ataupun quality tak bagus. So, asyik keluar masuk internet teruk, contoh kan? Jadi, that is how we perceive quality because different. If I have like in here, I have 8 students, I have 8 difference of the quality satisfaction. Betul? Saya akan ada 8 orang yang mempunyai 8 jenis quality yang ditunjukkan. Mungkin ada orang dia tengok site tu kualitinya bagus. Ada orang mungkin tengok dari segi contentnya bagus. Jadi berbeza. Okay? And performance excellence. Okay, kalau dalam, I just want to share. If we talking about excellence, okay, excellency ataupun excellence itself, we talking about the best that we can perform. Okay? Apakah yang terbaik kita boleh buat atau persembahkan? What is the most prestasi yang kita boleh buat yang terbaik? So dalam bahasa Arab, excellence ni ataupun kita kata meet the benchmark. Menemui paras ukur, kayu ukur ke benchmark ni kan, kayu ukuran yang terbaik. Itu kita namakan perkataan Arabnya itqan, I-T-Q-A-N. Okay, itqan ni bermaksud apabila kita dapat mencapai satu paras ukur yang terbaik. Contoh nak dapat A dekat IIC, subjek A, okay, nak dapat grade A. Ataupun student selalu cakap, miss tak pula janji lulus. Okay, janji lulus berapa? 50 C. Betul? Itu paras ukuran performance dia untuk to pass. Tapi kalau kata performance excellence, dia kena dapat A. A plus. IC tak ada A plus. So kita ada A. Macam mana nak dapat A tu? 85. 85, you can get A for the excellence punya grade. Itu kita kata yang terbaik, yang paling terbaik. Kalau ada A+, 90 contohnya. Kalau kat universiti ada A+, You dapat 90, exam campur carry mark semua, final exam dapat 90, you get A plus. That one is the performance of your excellent grade in that subject. Okay. Jadi itu secara bahasa yang Bis nak mudahkan apa kita nak belajar dalam topik ni. Alright. So, jangan risau. Yang ni kita dah record. Bermakna insyaAllah nanti boleh tengok semula. Alright. The formal definitions of the quality. Okay. This is according to the text. Dia kata, the totality of the features and characteristic of a product or service that bears on its ability to satisfy the given need. Tadi Miss sebut pasal satisfaction. Because different person, different people, different customer, different consumer. Dah, Miss dah keluarkan dah. Okay. Apa beza, what's the difference between customer and consumer? Siapa tahu? Siapa pandai kat sini? Semua orang pandai. Semua orang kat tangan. Okay. Can someone tell me what's the difference between customer and consumer? Anyone? Customer?
Consumer is the one who consume the product. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay.
And then customer, we can't say that they are really going to buy the product. Maybe they came to just survey about the product.
Okay. Alright, thank you Ugesh. Almost there Ugesh. But
okay,
thank you Ugesh for your good try. Okay. The customer, okay, is more on product use. Macam Ugesh kata tadi, mungkin dia ada potential nak beli, want to use or not, want to buy or not the product. It's about product. Maksudnya, you can see physical product. You have handphone, you have drinks, you have food, okay? That is goes to the customer. But consumer, saya tulis juga dekat ruangan chat tu supaya mudah untuk nak screenshot ke apa. Consumer is must goes with services. Tadi you dengar, you guys sebut the person atau the people is use. Betul? Because services, kita selalunya gunakan. Sama lah kalau kita beli produk pun kita gunakan kan. Tapi we can't see the services but we can feel the service when we use it. Okay, let's say I give example like Grab. Grab is services or product? Siapa boleh jawab?
Services.
Okay, mesti ada jawapan sebab you are very near to the Grab kan. Okay, so yes, good. Ia adalah services but if you asking, okay, nowadays, Grab is considered as both. Meaning its products is also services. Why I said so? Because whatever that you choose from the Grab services, right, is the product. Grab takkan hantar dia je kat you, kan? Dia akan hantar produk makanan, ada yang mungkin guna untuk dokumen, kan? So, dia akan hantar. That is a product. So, Grab is considered product plus services. But mostly it's services. Because we have to install the punya apps and then we have to use it. We have to log in and then we have to make a pay. Again, and then done. And then the services is come to us. Okay? Ready in front of your door, right? Okay, so that is both. So, giving to say this, to satisfy the given needs, the keywords kat sini kan, to satisfy the given needs, meaning to say all of the particular, whether the customer or the consumer, have to meet their satisfaction. Tu je. Then you can have the characteristic of the quality. That is according to the American Society for Quality lah. Okay, ini yang dikatakan oleh kita kata society lah, persatuan American. Tapi ini dia punya definitions lah. Alright, definition given by the three most popular quality management gurus. Selalu ni memang we cannot deniable, we cannot avoid. When you see the name, you know automatically this is the quality gurus. Kita panggil scholars, kita panggil pioneer, kita panggil professor, kita panggil apa lagi perkataan dia yang bila kita sebut tentang konsep quality management, kita tak dapat lari daripada tiga nama ni. Okay. So the first one you can see in here is the Dr. Joseph Juran. So Dr. Joseph Juran is actually from Japan. Okay. This guy is from Japan. You can Google for you maybe interested to know who is this guy. You just type Joseph Juran then you can see the face. Instead, the quality management is about a fitness for use. Maksudnya quality tu ataupun quality management, pengurusan quality ini, dia menyebabkan ataupun adalah sesuatu penggunaan yang fit for you. Baru dia berkualiti. Apa yang selalu kalau kita tergambarkan bila kita kata fit for you? Boleh siapa-siapa bagi tahu ni? Contoh, fitness for use. Apa maksud dia? Apa contoh produk ataupun services yang bila kita guna, it's fit for you? Fitness. Fitness tu apa yang bersesuaian, yang bertepatan dengan you? Apa yang selalu tergambar? Oh, sesuai ni dengan you ni. Apa yang kita boleh tergambar? Contoh.
Clothes.
Thank you, Ilham. Ya, yeah, clothes. Right. Kalau kita pakai baju macam ketat tu, macam ketat baju tu tak sesuai kan? Kan? It's about clothes ataupun kita kata shoes. Apa-apa yang nampak exactly physical. Itu product. So, it's customer kan? Product customer use. So, it's fitness for use. Ataupun mungkin kita boleh kata macam ubat-ubatan. Okay? Medication. Ataupun macam kalau kita tengok contohlah zaman sekarang kan, orang nak memutihkan kulit. Cleansing kan? Product whitening ke apa kan? You see some like dulu dia hitam. Oh, bukan hitam lah. Macam agak gelap mungkin kulitnya. Skin is very like very dark. But after use the product, it's like very white. Kita tengok dia very like fair kan? Kita tengok. So meaning to say, the product is fit for them. Ataupun dia guna mungkin produk-produk pelansingan ni. Ini yang Miss tak gemar dengar isu ni. Miss dan makanan tu dekat macam tu kan? Jadi, bila kita sebut mungkin ada certain mungkin supplement ataupun it's like a product they want to make you slim, slimming tea ke, and it fit for you, then you can also refer to that. Okay? If it, unless it's not given any side effect to you, it means it's quality. Kalau dia dah bagi side effect, you kena sampai mungkin bila you consume ataupun you use the product and then it affect to you, mean negative effect lah. Kalau dia good effect, fine. When negative effect to you, it will be not quality. It's not appropriate and not fit for use. Okay. Alright. The second one, we have Dr. W. Edward Deming, or we call Edward Deming. I don't think so. This guy is from Japan. Okay. Something like I'm from the western part country, but which country? I'm not go thoroughly with this research. A predictable degree of uniformity and dependability at low cost and suit to the market. For example, meeting or exceeding the customer expectation. Okay. Boleh tahu atau nak test you punya knowledge ni? Dekat mana kita nak tengok selalunya lah kita cerita tentang situasi sekarang at this condition current right now pandemic COVID-19. Where we can see the customer expectation or customer satisfaction, where we can refer to? Dekat mana? Siapa pandai? Semua pandai ni, cuma dia segan nak on dia punya audio tu atau nak type tu. Dekat mana kita boleh tengok? Oh, bagus produk ni. Dekat mana kita boleh refer? Apa kita namakan benda tu? Mesti dah belajar kan?
Review.
Okay, very good. Review. Ataupun kita panggil sebagai testimoni. Sebab dekat review testimoni, kalau kat Shopee kita tengok dia punya bintang. Kalau kita tengok kat Lazada dia punya komen, you can see in there. Kan? You rasa suka-suka ke seller tu dia buat ruangan tu untuk apa? Especially Shopee platform kan, because when other customer or consumer see the comments, they can see how much is their services, the seller services towards you and how good the products are. Jadi nak meet satisfaction tu senang je. Meet satisfaction the customer. Kalau customer bagi 5 bintang, walaupun dia tak tulis pun ayat, dia letak 5 bintang, good quality, good product, satisfactory with seller, lalu kan terbaik seller ni, recommend, that is walaupun a few words, tetapi sebenarnya dia mempengaruhi how the buying punya kita panggil behavior. Manusia ni, human being, kita mudah terpengaruh. Kalau kata-kata baik, okay, baik-baik. Kalau jahat, jahat. Jahat-jahat sekali kan. Okay, buat warrior kan. Kita nak tengok yang positif punya komen tu. So, that is actually meet the customer expectation. Or else, the customer experience itself. Okay, you tanya buat interview ataupun survey sendiri pada customer tu. How do you feel about this product? So dia bagi tahu. That is also we can see, okay, the uniformity. Sebenarnya senang dekat komen lah macam kawan cakap tadi, review kan. Everything is review about the good of that product and also services. And then conformance to the expectation. Conformance to specification. Conformance ni maksudnya you menepati, you meet the criteria that is according to the Philip Crosby. Okay, so Philip Crosby is totally from Western Cotton Park punya researcher jugalah, daripada negara-negara orang putih ni, negara-negara barat. So kata Philip, apabila sesuatu produk ke atau services menepati spesifikasi, maka ia terjatuh dalam kita kata hukum, hukum quality management ni sebagai the quality product. Okay, soalan ni, dekat mana kita nak tengok meet the specification tu? Contoh kalau electrics product. Okay, can you help me on that? Electrics or electronic product, how we want to make sure that product is meet the quality standard? Dekat mana kita nak tengok? Ada siapa-siapa nak jawab? Dekat mana kita nak tengok? Tak ada jawapan. Tak ada siapa nak type. Conformance to specification. Product electric or electronic product. Kita beli serika. Kita beli television. Atau we use like what we call computer, handphone. Where we can see the quality specification or quality standard. The product mix. Kalau terdengar bunyi-bunyi tu, Miss minta maaf ya. Dekat mana kita nak tengok? Tak ada jawapan. Okay. Kalau contohnya, Miss tak ada benda yang nak tunjuk ni. Okay. Kalau contohnya, yang paling meet the criteria, meet the criteria, number one, dia akan ada something we call as serim. Serim. Kalau you mungkin miss tak faham lah what is serim. Mungkin Aina ke tak faham what is serim kan?
Yes, tak faham.
Tak faham kan? Okay, sekejap Aina. Miss tutup. Kalau miss tutup, tutup tak komputer miss sekejap eh. Yeah. Like this. Nampak ke? Nampak tak serim ni? S-I-R-I-M.
Yeah, miss.
Yeah, I can see.
That it's is almost everywhere.
Yes. The serim in Malaysia, Aina, in Malaysia is actually a part of the quality assurance. Okay. Institution to ensure that the product electric, electronic, I believe there are other services too, must get from this institution to make sure it meets specification because it's involving safety. Apa-apa produk lah, semua produk lah melibatkan keselamatan terhadap pengguna tu sendiri kan. Jadi dia kena dapatkan dulu. Sebab tu kalau produk from China yang you beli, somehow it's very difficult we want to find this serum. Because dia tak ada. Dia tak ada, tapi mungkin organisation dekat sana adalah dia punya namanya. Tetapi kalau product from Malaysia, dia ada MS which is Malaysian Standard and dia mesti ada serim ini. Okay. So this serim is to conformant to the specification. Selamat digunakan. Kalau ada cop serim, tiba-tiba guna kat you meletup, there must be something wrong. Sama ada the serim been what we call do some fraudulent ataupun ada buat kita panggil macam copyrights. Maksudnya tipu lah, non-genuine punya serim. Dekat serim ni sendiri, dia ada dia punya label. You can check. Dia ada macam cara lah macam mana you boleh check if genuine or not. So for electric and electronic product, my recommendation is better you to buy from the platform that you are is to use, number one, and is to familiar. Senang awak familiar dengan sesuatu tu. Jadi anything happen, you can claim back for your money. Sebab ni melibatkan keselamatan eh. Bukannya kita saja-saja nak ber- kalau kita ni mungkinlah you all semua sini orang kata have-have kan. Beli TV sekali pakai meletup. Sekali beli meletup. Beli banyak kali. Wah kalau macam tu pun lingkup lah kalau 20 kali buka TV meletup-meletup kan. Jadi kita nak supaya produk tu selamat untuk pengguna. Dan ada dia punya of course the warranty lah. The warranty to ensure that the customer can claim back their money if anything happen is not meet to the specification. Sebenarnya untuk subjek quality ni dia banyak series you know. Dia bukan satu subjek je macam kita belajar kat dekat IIC ni. Dia banyak series. You kena belajar pasal green book. You kena belajar pasal yellow book. Dia sebab because it involve safety and health. Okay? Alright. So we moving to the next one. Kalau ada apa-apa soalan sila lah eh. Type ke tanya ke dekat tepi ni. Okay. So defining quality yang ada perkataan-perkataan dia. Perfection ada yang cakap the most perfectionist yang terbaik. Tak ada cacat celah ni. No defect product. Perfection. Or fast delivery. Sebab tu Miss kata if I have 8 my student in this class. So meaning to say there have also 8 satisfaction. So maybe your satisfaction will be a part in here. Criteria quality tu lah. Maybe in term of fast delivery. Kalau seller ni bagus. Hari ni order petang sampai. Wah contoh dia kan. Ataupun hari ni order esok dah sampai. Fast delivery. Providing a good usable product. Product tu boleh digunakan. Jadi tak tipu. Mean 100% is a quality. Yeah. Consistency, maksudnya sentiasa konsisten. Sama je bila kita order produk dengan dia, sama je kualitinya. Tak ada kalau macam produk makanan kan. Sekejap masin, sekejap tawar, sekejapnya manis sangat. Jadi they have consistency. Mungkin juga time, consistency. Bila hantar tu order hari ni, esok sampai order ni tak pernah yang terlewat lah. Okay, consistency. Eliminating waste, maksudnya mengurangkan pembaziran. Ini actually Japanese punya kita panggil rules. Eliminate waste. Jangan ada pembaziran. Sebab apa? Pembaziran itu sebahagian daripada perangai syaitan. Jadi kita tak nak ada some the wasted when we are doing the production and doing it right the first time. Buat yang terbaik. Kan kadang-kadang kita selalu kita dengar orang kata kalau kita solat tu, umpama kan solat tu solat terakhir. So, umpama kita akan mati lepas ni. Jadi bila kita buat, buat yang terbaik. Doing it first, right at the first time. Walaupun orang kata saya pertama, macam sejak tadi, walaupun saya, this is my first time teaching this quality management, I try my best to do the best for my student. You cannot compare with me like with Madam Suhana because Madam Suhana is already forte in this subject. Tapi I try my best to be like her. To be and to make it the first right lah. Kita nak buat yang terbaik kan. Okay, delighting or pleasing the customer. Delighting ni kita memberi yang terbaik dan kita memuaskan hati. Pleasant the customer. Kita nak supaya customer tu puas hati dengan kita. And total customer service and satisfaction. Meaning to say when you bagi perkhidmatan kepada pelanggan tu memberi secara total, keseluruhan. Kalau dia needs our punya assistant, dia perlukan pertolongan kita, where should I refer tu? Lagi zaman COVID ni kan susah sangat kita nak dapatkan proper customer service kan. So maybe some company tu very good. Dia ada customer service yang tengah orang kata standby 24 hours to assist you if you have any problem when buying their products at online, okay. And pleasing, pleasing ni kita kata memuaskan hati customer tu lah. And also kita ada juga compliance with policies and procedure. Ini sekarang SOP, what is SOP? Standard of procedure. Jadi when we want to sell to the customer right now, kalau kita tengok dekat most of kita panggil brick and mortar atau physical stores, kita kena ada number one, kena ada QR code My Sejahtera. When you scan there, make sure it exists. Your business is exist, and then ada book, logbook for those who do not have this My Sejahtera, you can just jot down in there. And then you must have the what we call thermometer to check on the your what we call temperature, okay, if exceed 37 degrees and then you are not be allowed to entering the premise. That is the policy, compliance with the policy. It's about quality, okay, and then make sure only a few customer is entering the premise. Ini kalau kita tengok kat Tesco, kat Giant kan, they only allowed maybe like 30 first entry ada 30 person, and then after that the other customer will be allowed to go when already exit by the previous one. Jadi dia will system giliran lah. Kita tak boleh masuk secara ramai-ramai, cannot pack. They must also have to be compliance with these policies and procedure. Okay, so for now ada apa-apa soalan? Awal lagi kan? Okay, alright, thank you Gesh. Okay, so the importance of the quality. Apakah kepentingan quality ni? So dekat sini dia kata the buzzword among their business in the 1980s and 1990s. Diorang akan tanya, penting ke quality ni? So this is a buzzword. So quality problems still abound in many industries such as automotive, betul? Kita tak nafikan, we cannot deny dalam industri pemotoran ni quality problems yang sentiasa ada lah, yang sentiasa wujud. Kalau dulu Proton, kita asyik dengar problematic quality kereta dari Proton. After China take over ni, I think that there must be more improvement lah. Saya tak tahu siapa ada, you all setuju tak dengan Miss? Tapi apa yang Miss tengok macam tu lah. Kalau dulu ada je problem dengan tingkapnya, dengan windowsnya, dengan lightingnya, macam-macam problem pada model keluaran kereta daripada Proton. It's not comparable with the Produa ke atau like NASA ke kan, kereta-kereta. Dan kita tak boleh compare lah dengan daripada kereta import. Kereta import sentiasa meet the quality standards tu. And the consumer expectations are high. Customer ni ataupun consumer ni, dia biar bayar sikit tetapi dia punya expectation, dia punya quality is very high. Okay, dia mesti akan fight for dia punya quality standard because they believe the first, apa yang selalu kita dengar kan, quality ataupun is better than quantity, betul? And the customer is always right. You all adalah customer kami, IIC. Kami ni adalah actually kita panggil apa? Giving our services to you all. Macam tu kan? Customer always right. Tapi student not always right. Okay. Kita pun not always right. Okay. So sama-sama kita improvise ourselves. And we've met the dependence on the quality of our technology a part of life. Dia kata kita buat sesuatu kebergantungan pada quality, quality of our technology. Dia kata quality of our technology tu adalah technology tu a part of quality in our life. Jadi dia tak boleh lari lah. Bila kita berkait dengan teknologi ni, ia adalah salah satu quality in our life. Contoh kalau kita ambil lah macam kereta Toyota, kan Toyota daripada Jepun kan. Mereka adalah satu yang negara yang mengamalkan sistem JIT, just in time. Nanti kita akan pergi further lah pasal method ni. Yang mana rata-rata mereka mengamalkan sistem yang sangat jemat-jemat. Kalau contoh dia nak keluarkan 30,000 lah kereta kan. Dan dia memerlukan 30,000 compartment ataupun apa-apalah benda part compact, what we call part, some benda-benda dalam kereta kan. Dia akan pastikan untuk keluarkan particular parts tu dalam ikut quantity kereta tersebut. Ngam-ngam sui. Nak dengar tak terms tu? Cukup-cukup. Dia takkan go for extra. Sebab for them, we have to eliminate the waste. Kita kena mengurangkan pembaziran tu. Mengurangkan terus macam supaya tak ada pembaziran tu berlaku. That is Japan lah. As you know, Japanese when they do something, they must start with doing it right at the first time. Dia buat yang terbaik. Itu kita suka. Sebab tu kalau awak ingat Tun Mahathir, dia selalu kata, dia punya motto, dia kata apa, dia punya vision, look to the east, pandang ke timur. Sebab pandang ke timur ni merujuk kepada kita tidak bergantung harap kepada western counterpart tau. Kita melihat kepada sudut memandang kepada timur tu, iaitu di Jepun. Konsep Islam tu dah lama wujud, tahu. Tetapi tidak ada dalam negara Islam, tapi ada dalam negara bukan Islam, iaitu Jepun. Awak tak percaya, awak boleh go through it lah. Miss Han just share benda ni. Okay, lepas history ni, Miss stop. Miss tahu awak mesti macam, ya Allah Miss, first class ni takkan nak habis semua. Taklah. Miss just nak bagi macam awak, macam kita kata, macam warm up. Okay, dah lama kita tak belajar kan. Okay. Alright. So the first one, history of quality assurance. Okay, apa beza ni assurance and insurance? Insurance lah. Assurance ni, macam mana kita nak pastikan kepastian. Apa lah dalam bahasa Melayu dia? Kita sesungguhnya, kita pasti kualiti tu ada. Mesti ada. Okay. So dia kata, it start during the skill craftsmanship during middle age. So middle ages ni, waktu pertengahan, kurun ke berapa. Dan saya percaya ini zaman ketika Perang Dunia Pertama. Sebab early 20th century. Bila Perang Dunia Pertama? Siapa pandai kat sini? Semua pandai. Siapa tahu bila tahun Perang Dunia Pertama? When is the World War II? Sorry. When is the World War I? Siapa tahu? Ada jawapan ni senyap ni.
When, 1940.
Ha? 1914.
1914.
Betul. Ke 1920? 1914. Okay. Alright, good. Ada someone yang berjaya. Okay, World War I is 1914. So selalunya Miss mengajar, Miss akan sebut 1920 tau Ilham. Okay, because that is during the era. But it starting is 1914. And 1920, kalau you tengok, during that time, mostly they are doing craft. Craft ni yang ukir-ukir. Ukir kapal, ukir arca. Zaman tu lah dia suka buat kerja yang craftsman lah. So dia kata, during the Industrial Revolution, rise of the inspection and separate the quality department. So mereka start untuk wujudkan pada zaman ketika itu untuk lihat macam ada department yang untuk check quality lah. Betul tak ukiran tu, ikut tak standard, bentuk lengkuknya. Sebab ketika tu kan baru mula-mula kita kata kualiti tu terjaga. Early 20th century, statistical method at Bell system. Ni yang dia mula gunakan lah method-method ni. Dia berbentuk numbering. Sebab awak tengok statistical. Dia ada satu program yang dibuat dipanggil Bell system. And then, the quality control during the World War II. Okay, kalau Ilham kata 1914, Aina kata juga 1914, bermaksud, okay, 1914 tu adalah World War I. So, World War II terjadi 1946, 1946. Maksud tu kalau kita ingat dekat Malaysia, orang Jepun, okay, tentera Jepun menyerang, datang menjajah di Malaysia. Around that lah, 1946, 1940. That is the World War II. And the post-war Japan, the evolution of quality management. Dan ia berkait. Sebab bila diorang start datang, mereka mengamalkan sistem Jepun mereka. Because that post-war Japan, the evolution of the quality management. When we talking about quality, is undeniable. We talking about Japanese ataupun Japan country. Kita tak dapat elak. Memang orang akan kaitkan Jepun ni, this from Japan, kan? Awak tengok contoh produk dia pada Jepun. Siapa tahu satu produk yang memang ada kat Malaysia dari Jepun? Siapa tahu? Sebut satu brand, brand name. Yang sampai sekarang masih ada.
Honda.
Toyota dari Jepun kan?
Sony, yeah, so. Toyota, Honda.
Pandai.
Suzuki.
Toyota. Pandailah semua lah kelas ni. Tak naklah Miss saja semua pandai sangat. Okay. Toyota. Tadi Miss dengar Sony. Honda. Kan? Banyak sebut kereta kan? Panasonic, kalau orang sebut daripada Jepun, orang akan cakap produk-produk ni. Sebab produknya berkualiti. Okay, produknya sangat berkualiti dan kita takkan nafikan susah kita nak jumpa defect lepas lama digunakan. Dan kalau macam kereta, dekat Jepun, lepas ataupun sebelum 5 tahun, kita tak boleh guna. Kita kat Malaysia, selagi boleh kereta tu guna 30 tahun, gunalah 30 tahun. Tapi kita bayar kereta sampai 10 tahun je kan? Atau 9 tahun. Selagi boleh guna selagi tu. Tak sebab tu kereta-kereta yang lebih tempoh daripada 5 tahun, mereka takkan gunakan. Mereka takkan bazirkan di jalan raya. Sebab tahu kereta tu mungkin long lasting around that. Pada kita kalau kita tengok, bagus Honda ni kan. Dah dapat kita pakai lebih daripada 5 tahun, bagus. Pada mereka tidak. This is how they control dia punya quality. A good things lah yang kita boleh cakna, kita boleh ambil. Apa yang patut di Malaysia kita ikut seperti mereka. Okay? Alright. So kita pergi kepada yang seterusnya. Masih lagi dalam history of quality assurance. Okay. Laju pula slide ni. Okay. Quality awareness in US manufacturing industry during 1980s from little Q to the big Q. Ha, ni dia punya term sah eh. Little Q to big Q, maksud little quality to big quality is total quality management process tu secara overall. Dia tak terus big quality. Dia bermula daripada asas kecil-kecilan sampai jadi big quality. Okay. So dia kata kat sini Malcolm Baldrige National Quality Award 1987. Nah, ini untuk certain ataupun kita kata company yang berjaya memiliki big Q tu, mereka akan dianugerahkan award ni. Satu company yang ada ISO 9000 standard, yang ada quality award ni, bermakna company tersebut fulfill the specification and requirement of quality standard. Dia bukan sahaja bagi penghargaan tu sebab company tu beli. Tak. So dia kata kat sini, they have disappointments and criticism towards that. Biasalah bila kita baru buat sesuatu, pelaksanaan award ke apa recognition, dia akan berlakunya argument, kenapa kena buat macam ni, kenapa kena buat macam ni. Jadi berlakunya banyak kritik tetapi digunapakan sehingga kini. Okay, that is other issue about disappointments and criticism. Okay, and then the last one, dia kata the emergence of the quality management in service, dia menggantikan Malcolm tadi kepada yang ni yang dinamakan sebagai evolution of Six Sigma. Kita ada emergence of quality management in service industry, government, healthcare and education. Okay, termasuk kita lah IIC ya. And the current and future challenge, maintain commitment to the performance excellence. Okay. Alright, so Miss rasa Miss akan stop dekat sini. Nanti kita akan sambung balik. Saya percaya sampailah hujung minggu ni masih ada kawan-kawan yang add and drop. Sebab ada yang mungkin masalah kewangan kan, yang tak settle lagi. Ramai pelajar Miss kan, yang macam akhir-akhir tahun ni kesian. Semester, dua semester lepas lah masa mula-mula kita buat practice online ni, mereka terpaksa kerja sebab nak bayar tuition fees. I tolerate on that lah. Saya nak cakap pun nanti saya sedih. Saya tak nak cakap lah. Okay. Alright. So without further ado, saya akan panggil nama. Nanti jawab eh. Sebab ni terus ambil attendance. Walaupun awak dah tanda. Miss kena ambil juga. Miss kena ambil untuk rekod Miss lah. Nanti kalau Miss tak ambil, nanti kata macam mana Miss dah tahu kan student Miss datang ke tak. Okay. So pada siapa yang belum masuk NIO, sila masuk dengan kadar segera eh. Accept dulu dalam email, then awak akan masuk. Siapa yang belum ada NIO ni ada dua tau. Untuk bawah SOM, dia ada SOM 1, SOM 2. So macam Miss di bawah account NIO 1, SOM 1. Jadi kadang-kadang student kata, Miss saya dah ada account NIO. Tapi kenapa saya tak boleh masuk? Maknanya itu SOM 2. So SOM 1 awak belum ada lagi. Okay? Alright. Sementara Miss merepek-merepek ni, kalau merepek, Miss nak cari attendance ni. Betul ke ada 8 orang je? Setakat ni. Okay. Alright. Kita ada Ugnesh. Hadir eh Ugnesh?
Yes, Miss.
Ugnesh. Okay. Hazwan.
Ada, Miss.
Okay. Muhammad Faris.
Yes, Miss.
Okay, Anas Haikal. Ada ke Anas? Ada eh. Shazlin. Shazlin ada.
Yes.
Okay, Muhammad Irham. Irham, yes, Muhammad Irham.
Ada.
Okay, Nur Ain Hazikah.
Yes, miss.
Okay, Ilham Putra.
Yes, miss.
Okay, Farhani Aina.
Yes, miss.
Okay, thank you so much. So, Aina ataupun semualah, kalau you have any question, if you have any question, please do not hesitate to just drop down your question at the group WhatsApp. I will try to entertain you all, okay? And yeah, this will be, I will share this record version video to our class later when I got the link, and then you can, yeah, you can revise and start to explore the new. Okay, any question more student to ask? Ada soalan dan mau tanya?
No.
Yeah, tak ada eh? Okay, alright. Thank you for joining me today. Tak apa ke? Ada 15 minit lagi ni. Cuma miss faham lah sebab tengah hari kan nak pergi makan ke.
Tak apa madam.
Tak apa. Tak apa madam. I mean miss.
Laju you all kan? Okay. Sebab miss pun sama. So miss pun macam nak masak apa semua. Okay. Thank you Aina. Okay. So yeah, take care eh. Jaga diri baik-baik. InsyaAllah kita jumpa minggu depan ya. Alright. Assalamualaikum.
Okay,
bye.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, miss.
Alright.
Thank you.
Bye. Okay.